Hi, everyone. Good Thursday afternoon. Meteorologist Griffin Hardy here with an update on your forecast. Thanks for logging on for it. Beautiful day out there for July with lower humidity. Like we talked about yesterday, remnants of Beryl have pulled some drier air our way, so it's a really nice day up in the mountains, 85 degrees. Dew point is 60, which is pretty low for this time of year. North winds really helping us out today. Same story in the upstate as well. Lots of sunshine and a little hot, but feeling really good. The humidity is actually lower in the upstate compared to the mountains with the dew point at 59 here in Greenville. Northeast winds coming a bit breezy at times, 13 miles per hour right now. That lower humidity is there across the upstate, the mountains, and farther east towards Charlotte. Down towards the coast, though, they are on the opposite side of a stalled front, so they've got some downpours that are happening over there. Even some flash flooding just to the east of Raleigh. There's a much deeper moisture that we would typically see on a summer's day over on this side of the front, and it's stalled for the moment, but it's actually going to be moving back towards the west tomorrow. That's part of the reason why I'm expecting the humidity to be a little bit higher tomorrow, as well as us having a small chance for rain, mostly across the eastern half of the area. Not for tonight, though. It stays nice and quiet. Lots of sunshine this evening. No chance of pop-up showers or storms for tonight. It's rare that we can actually say that on a summer's night, but that's one of those nights for sure. Tonight is one of those nights. Mostly clear and upper 70s by around 11 o'clock tonight, and we'll wake up to mild temperatures tomorrow morning, upper 60s to low 70s across the upstate, low to mid 60s for western North Carolina, close to the average for this time of year. There comes that small chance for rain across the eastern half of the area a little early in the day, starting at around noon tomorrow towards places like Lawrence, Union, and Gaffney. The farther west you go in our area, the less likely you are to see any chance of pop-up showers tomorrow. It looks like it'll be mostly just farther east you go, where we actually have some better moisture amounts. Most of us farther west, though, are probably going to stay sunny and get pretty hot tomorrow, 93 to 94 by late in the day towards Clemson and Anderson. Some spots hitting 95, like Hartwell and Elberton. But it's not going to be a washout by any means. I think most of us will stay dry. It's just the farther east you go, the better chance you have of showers. Stays relatively quiet heading into Saturday morning. And for Saturday afternoon into the weekend, this is where the heat starts to dial back up a little bit, noticeably so. Most places getting up to around 95 to even 96 for Saturday afternoon. That kicks off a pretty strong heat wave that's going to be taking shape on Sunday and lasting all the way until Wednesday. Check out your future temperatures. I'm putting an impact day in place now for Sunday, as it now looks like we'll probably hit 97 to 98 across much of the area, 98 to 99 for Monday, and it just keeps on going. Most likely we'll hit 100 degrees again in Greenville on Tuesday, like we did last Friday, where we hit 101. We're close to that century mark on Tuesday afternoon, it looks like, as well as for Wednesday, upper 90s still on the board. So four straight impact days because of the heat. Now, the humidity won't be high enough for us to see, you know, excessive heat warnings. I think it's likely that we'll probably get some heat advisories issued, but the heat index looks like it will top out around 104 to 105. Normally, excessive heat warnings are issued whenever we have a heat index of 110. So it's going to be really hot no matter how you slice it, but not really into the most dangerous category of heat that we could see. So here's the updated rain chances over the next 7 days. Spotty for tomorrow, again, mostly farther east. Rain chances have gone down a bit since yesterday for the weekend. Saturday and Sunday, we're going to be mainly dry, as well as for Monday. It's not really until Wednesday, Thursday that we have a decent chance of getting more heavier downpours as we get deeper moisture amounts through the second half of next week. So for the foreseeable future, it's probably going to be mainly dry and just really hot heading into early next week. Updated drought monitor for today, which shows we haven't really had that much improvement despite the rain that we had this past weekend. Still in a moderate drought across a good swath of the western half of the upstate, as well as severe drought down towards Lawrence and Union counties. So the rain is still beneficial, and it doesn't look like we're going to get much of it over the next 5 to 6 days. It's mostly just going to be the heat. That's the main story. So here's what I've got for the 4 day. More humid with a few showers farther east across our area. Saturday, we're partly cloudy and hot, 95 to 96, broadly speaking. The impact days take shape on Sunday with highs around 97 to 98, and then it stays in the upper 90s to low 100s Monday, Tuesday, and into Wednesday. But the good news is, at least the heat hits the brakes a little bit by the time you get to Thursday afternoon. I think the pattern shifts by then to where we get some more winds out of the northwest as opposed to just upper-level ridging, so That should help us out by Thursday. Better chance for showers and storms, and at least a little reprieve from the really intense heat, where highs will be in the upper 90s to low 100s. For the 4-day plus for the mountains, it's a similar story here, just not as hot. Low to mid 90s as opposed to upper 90s, low 100s for Saturday through Tuesday and Wednesday, with again just slight chances for pop-up showers and storms. A little bit tomorrow, not much over the weekend and the start of next week, and then Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. That's when those pop-up showers and storms make a comeback.